So here's the deal. Despite the Lakers being eliminated from the postseason, LeBron James wanted to finish out the season, but the team's medical staff convinced him otherwise, that according to Luke Walton, which you just heard. So the Lakers announced this weekend that James would be held out the final six games to allow his strained left groin to fully heal. Stephen A., how should we look at LeBron now that he needed to be convinced to shut it down?
I think we need to look at him in a positive way. Now, obviously, that's falling prey to exactly what LeBron wants, because you know how I am about how he tries to control the narrative at every turn. But in this particular instance, it's well-earned, and he should want to control this. The fact of the matter is that LeBron James played all 82 games last year. Mm-hmm. He missed the 18 games this year due to his injury. He came back, worked his way back into shape and into better health, and performed, and his numbers are similar. Now, you could sit up there and say he's playing for his numbers. Some people could make that argument, and they might have, it might have a degree of credence and substance to it. But it doesn't negate the fact that he went out there and he was performing. And here's the biggest thing for me, and this is why I will forever love an MJ. I will forever love a Kobe and people like that. And to a lesser degree, the Russell Westbrooks of the world. You're the marquee. You know it, and you show up. It doesn't matter what your mood is. It doesn't matter how tired you are. You'll be sore, hurt, whatever. You show up. Isaiah Thomas was once running the Toronto Raptors franchise. And as much as the historically speaking, the history between him and MJ was suspect. When you talk about having an appreciation for MJ, Max, this is one of those moments when Isaiah Thomas had to give it up. Toronto was an expansion franchise, and Michael Jordan had played, and he was absolutely, positively exhausted. But it meant everything to the franchise at that particular moment in time for Michael Jordan to show up and play, because this is Canada, for crying out loud. There were no NBA teams. You didn't get to see MJ. Mm-hmm. MJ knew it, and MJ showed up. You know, it meant everything to them. And when you have a star that's the marquee and they act like it, you got to give credit where credit is due. And that is what I appreciate about LeBron in this instance. You the marquee. Y'all ain't going to the playoffs. I got it. But you showed up.
Look, LeBron has been playing right out of high school.
Right.
And never took a couple years away from the game as Michael Jordan did, and never missed most of a season as Michael Jordan did early, and then played 82 games last year. Just quickly about
that was the injury though. Because Michael Jordan played all
quickly about
games
MJ
about 7, 8 times.
Yeah. Quickly about MJ.
Yeah.
So he missed most of his second season. He played 18 games, and when he came back after he played 17 games, but otherwise, I'm just going to read you his games totals other than those two seasons: 82, 82, 82, 81, 82, 82, 80, 78, 82, 82, 82. Then he came back also to 60-game season because he came.
Yep.
And then last season of his career, 39 years old, 82.
That's right.
And he averaged over his career over 38 minutes a game.
That is correct.
So I understand that LeBron has been trying to kind of and has that mentality. Mm-hmm. And especially last year, he's like, let me play a full 82-game season, which nowadays is different. There's higher intensity on every play, although Jordan was also like a defensive all-time great throughout his career. Mm-hmm. Look, this looks bad for the Lakers. And the reason it looks bad for the Lakers is I understand coming back from a strained groin. Now, everyone has experienced this groin hamstring, mm-hmm. right? That's not the kind of thing where you can play it back into shape or something, right? The soreness will go away. The soreness will keep getting worse. Because when you hear strained groin or hamstring, really what you're saying is there's a little micro tear in the muscle. Mm-hmm. That tear does not have time to heal if you keep using it. I understand when you're still in the playoff hunt, coming back and playing, like, it's going to get worse, but you got to try, right? Once it was clear they weren't going to make the playoffs, if it was as bad as it now appears it was, why is he playing any minutes? Oh, because he wanted to. That's on the Lakers. That's like a corner man in boxing. I know you want to go out for the last round, but and if it was the 12th round of a championship fight, maybe I'd let you, but it's not. It's the 8th round, and the title's not on the line. You ain't fight. You'll live to fight another day. Why did the Lakers let him play at all on this thing? You got him to a 4-year deal, and you're eliminated from the playoffs.
Well, I can answer that question. It's not going to suffice for you. Probably won't suffice for me, but I can give you the rationale. You've missed the playoffs 5 consecutive years. You've given the fans little to nothing to cheer about. And you know that you're going home in April, which means you got half of April, then May, June, July, August, and September, and half of October before. So you got 6 months off. So the mentality is, you got 6 months to heal. You'll be all right. And in the meantime, we got these paying customers in Tinseltown that want something to cheer about. And Grant Ingram and Kuzma and Lonzo ain't going to cut it. And that was before Lonzo got injured. That's why.
Yeah. All it tells me is that these games are meaningless. And he's more focused on the overall picture.
The 6 months off is a good point, though, because he's never had 6 months off ever.
He's only had three. He's never had six. He's going to have 6 months off now.